I was 16 years old, and my brother brought me to his friend's place. He reached into this old closet and pulled this piece of wood out, had no finish left on it, and strings on it probably older than me, and he said, "Hey, want to try my guitar?" I said, "Geez, how old's that?" He said, "It's a 1963 Strat." I said, "Oh, okay, I didn't know much about it at the time, an old guitar." And I put it on, put my hand around it, and it blew my mind. And that was about, that was a lot of years ago now, so I haven't slept well ever since then. So I've been pretty much coveting the idea of somehow acquiring one of these holy grails. And I recently did, and I'm very, 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 very happy about that. This guitar here is a 1963 Fender Stratocaster L series. It's got a wicked low number, L00308. The neck is stamped February 2nd, 1963. It used to belong to a fellow named Chris Stockley. Chris Stockley was the lead guitar player from an Australian rock band in the 70s called the Dingoes. I believe they played around recently as well in a form of reunion. But they were a recording band and a touring band, so this guitar is seen its share of road work, hence the road-worn condition of it. Structurally, it's in fine shape, so it hasn't suffered at all. Again, quality of a fine old instrument. So anyhow, apparently he sold this guitar in the 70s. He parted with it, and it's been in Canada ever since. And through some miraculous channels, and for the plug right now, Will Hansen, my good buddy, he hooked me up. All original. There were a couple pieces that have been replaced apparently in the 70s. Some of these saddles were replaced. Three fretboard dots. The others are the original clay. And it did have a refret with jumbo frets instead of the vintage. Other than that, the clusens, the neck, the body, the pots, that's a replaced pot. The other pots are original. The pickups, original, hand wound. You can't beat the tone. I'm heading to a lot of great Strat players have played them over the years. Stevie Ray Vaughan's main guitar was a hybrid 62-63. Mark Knopfler in Dire Straits, you get that sound here. This has the old three-position switch instead of the five, so to get those old phase sort of sounds, they used to put it in the switch halfway and jam a matchstick in it. So that'll hold it in one place. So that was pretty cool. Anyhow, it holds itself pretty good, and I don't think I'll be jamming any matchsticks in it. But I'm in love. I love the thing. It's solid. It's got that classic Fender tone that you all love and desire. It's funny because, you know, I've played a lot of guitars and plugging through a lot of different amps and tweaked a lot of buttons to try and get that tone. This thing here, you seem to plug it into anything and it sounds right.
Vintage acoustic Gibson, vintage electric Fender. Let's put them together. This is what some people would call a marriage made in heaven. Let's see if you agree. One, two, three, hey!